final song.
Together. We even got matching sports bras. Oh. I was like, what is she doing? But look at our matching sports bras.
Boom.
So we have been working out, you know, going to the gym, getting fit with our personal trainer, Brock. We're going to be doing two workout routines, one on her channel and one on mine. And then we're going to be doing five tips and like healthy habits at the end of each of our videos. So, you know, foods, things you should buy, just tips and tricks and things like that. So we hope you guys find this video very beneficial, and let's just get right into this workout routine. Woo! And how to get in shape for summer. Woo! Okay, let's go.
It's time to pray to God. My revolver's not religious, the revolution's born. You wanna know my name, then go and tell us all.
So this is Brock. He is our personal trainer and we love messing with him and we always have a good time when we work out. So shout out to Brock. And now we're gonna get into our workout routine. So every time before we work out, I stretch and then I'm going to show you guys the warm-up that we do at our gym right here. So basically you can just copy all these motions, but we go back and forth down the hallway. And so we do these lunge, lunge, stretch, stretch, and then it's skip, skip, if that makes any sense. So you just go down the hallway and back and you do each of these exercises. I also apologize if I don't sound as energetic in this video. It's 1:30 a.m. and I also lost my voice, so I'm very sorry, but I promise you I'm happy. The next thing we do are these walkouts. You basically walk your hands out, do a push-up. You can even do two if you want to make it more challenging, and then walk your feet in. They're pretty hard, but man, they work. The next thing we do is we run as fast as we can for 45 seconds straight, and we repeat this three times. At first, you will be done. I mean, I still am done most of the times, but you get used to it, and it warms up your muscles, and Brock just has us do these, and they kill, but dang, they work. So I want to show you guys what leg workouts we did on this day. So basically we did these curtsy squats and you're going to do two sets of 10, and basically that means you're going to do 10 on each leg and repeat it twice. And then I didn't feel it as much, so I added a weight. You can add a weight for more of a challenge. Next we did these jumping lunges. You're going to do this for 1 minute straight on each leg and then repeat it twice. And next I did squats. Squats are a classic if you want to get, you know, bigger muscles on your legs and a bigger booty. I did two sets of 10 again, so I did 10 and repeated it twice. And then Brock is just there to ensure that we have the correct form, which is really helpful because sometimes I do the wrong thing. So moving on to arms, I'm going to show you guys four arm exercises. So Brock had me do these. I did two sets of 10, which these are actually really hard. Next we did these, which were also really hard. Make sure you breathe a lot during things like this, especially if you have heavier weights. Make sure you continue to breathe and do it nice and slow and steady. On these ones, we went on a foam roller and you try and keep your lower back really, really flat on the foam roller and just push the weights up. And again, we did two sets of 10. Next, we did these push-ups on our weights. It makes it a lot more challenging. So we did two sets of 10 of these, and make sure you keep your hips up. Brock just corrected mine, so make sure you keep your hips up. And then lastly, Brock had me do this, which I basically was holding my weight for 15 seconds, and you keep your knees tucked as high as you can, and then you lower yourself down for 5 seconds. It's really, really hard. It's, oh, killed me. Baby, take control now. next, moving on to abs, I'm going to show you guys three ab exercises, and we're starting with these ones, which are going to hold your weight, try and keep your hips up, and curl your weight underneath, and we did 2 sets of 10 on this one. For this next one, you're going to keep one of your legs up in the air and try and keep it as straight as possible, and then slowly dip the other leg, and then you're going to alternate this. You're going to do 15 on each leg and repeat it twice. Make sure you do it nice and slow and controlled, but you want to dip it down nice and slowly. And then next, you're going to hold your weight, and you're going to raise your leg up and down nice and slowly. You're going to do each leg for 1 minute and repeat it twice, and just try and keep your hips up as well on this one. So that was the workout routine, and now we're going to move on to the tips portion, and number one is food. So whenever I grocery shop, I try and get very healthy things. You definitely want to always stick to veggies, fruit, chicken, fish. Just stay away from processed foods. The outside of the grocery store normally has the healthy food, so stay in that region. Before I work out, I always try and eat something healthy but with some protein. So what I'll do is I'll spray some coconut oil in a pan, and then I will measure out 2 eggs since I have a carton, and I use egg whites because it's healthier and it's less fat. And then I'll do a little bit of salt and pepper. You can do normal eggs too, don't worry about it. I just like the egg whites. And then in combination with that, I get an apple and slice that up, and this is my pre-workout meal. And of course, I drink some water with it, and it's so delicious. Always after I work out, I drink a post-workout shake. I will link this protein powder down below, but I will do 6 to 7 ounces of water and then 1 scoop of this. Just shake it up in my blender. Definitely recommend you guys invest in one of these, and I will drink that afterwards because it allows you to gain muscle faster. So if you ever want to see results, consistency is key. So I will plan out my workouts. I will plan out when am I going to Vibe, when am I going to SoulCycle, when am I going to LA Fitness. It's just super important to kind of plan it out and stay consistent. Because if you're not consistent and you're not committed, you're not going to be seeing results. So I'll go ahead and plan out my week, book my SoulCycle at the beginning of the week, and things like that. That way I will stay on track. So some ways you can get motivated are the following. Number one is making a good music playlist, or just finding a good one. Music is so important to me when I work out. If I don't have good music, I feel like I can't work out as well. So get a good playlist. Number two is track your progress. This has been so beneficial for me. You can see how you're changing, how your body's doing, and it's super encouraging to look back at old pictures. So always take pictures of your progress. Number three, I know this is basic, but it's getting cute workout clothes. If I look good, I perform so much better. When I feel comfortable in the clothes, I do better. You don't have to go to Lululemon. TJ Maxx has plenty of good stuff, but just make sure you're comfortable in what you're wearing. Last but not least, find your inspiration. Pinterest and Instagram are riddled with inspiration. I love following fitness accounts. That is what pushes me. So definitely follow some so you can feel inspired and motivated. Another thing you can do that's good for your overall health is taking vitamins. And this is our trainer, John, or another one of the trainers at Vibe. He told us all the benefits and perks of taking vitamins, what they do, when you should take them. And he wrote a little article about it. So I'll have it listed down below so you guys can read into it and see what vitamins you should get. But they help you just gain muscle faster and lose weight faster. Another thing that's really crucial for losing weight and just being, you know, healthy is getting enough sleep. I'll use this thing on my phone underneath the clock app, and it lets me know when I need to go to sleep to get 8 hours. And then if I find that I'm not sleepy by like my certain bedtime, I'll take melatonin, these emergency packets which have melatonin in it. It makes you sleepier, faster, and it has vitamin C in it. That way I can get a good night's rest. And then before bed, I always drink water. Make sure you guys are always drinking water. So important. Carry a bottle around with you. It's super, super important. I didn't know what to call this one, so I'm titling it mental health, but how you view yourself and food when you're working out and losing weight is really important. You want to make sure it's a healthy view. So what I do is I set myself fitness goals. I kind of just made these up on the spot, but You want to make sure that you set yourself some goals so you can try to stick to them, and that you're not really worrying about, you know, the scale and numbers necessarily, but more how you feel and how your body looks in the mirror.
You can do it. You are a strong, independent woman who don't need a man. All you need is your weights and the gym. And I'm just kidding. But you got this. Let's be real.
I just made those goals up on the spot, basically, but when I look in the mirror, I mainly just want to see positive changes in my body. I never really worry about what is my weight, because muscle weighs a lot, so you could be gaining weight as you're working out. So don't necessarily worry about the scale. Worry about how you feel and just feeling confident and loving your body and loving the process. It does take time, so be patient with it. So the cravings will come. Make sure you treat yourself every now and then. Have a cheat day. Don't be mad at yourself if you cave every now and then. Don't deprive yourself. Like, treat yourself if you have been working hard.
Oh, how I missed you, bread. Little
baby. Jesus did say, I am the bread of life. He didn't say I'm the broccoli of life. So therefore, basically, Jesus is bread. So, AKA bread is not that bad. So it's okay to eat it, right? Yeah? I was trying to justify my actions, but I just love bread.
Overall, what I'm trying to say is, yes, be healthy, but if you slip up every now and then or have a cheat day, don't beat yourself up over it. Reward yourself every now and then. It's okay. And that's my video, guys.
So we hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful. We hope it inspired you, motivated you. Once again, make sure you check out Danny's video. It'll be linked down below and all of our social medias, because we post quite often about, you know, working out and our fitness routines on our Insta stories. And I post quite often my workout routine on my vlog channel. That's Janine TV. It'll be linked down below. So hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we'll see you very, very soon. Peace out, Girl Scout. Bye, guys.